Smart cities are fascinating, but the term is vague. What are smart cities? I'm Michael Krigsman. I'm an industry analyst and the host of CXOTalk. And I'm speaking with Martin Powell from Siemens, one of the world's leading experts on smart cities. Hey, Martin, how are you?
Very good. How are you?
What are you doing with smart cities?
We're doing lots of things. We are running a global business around energy infrastructure, transport infrastructure, building infrastructure. And what we do is really focus very heavily on how you combine all of that into the city space.
Why is the term smart city so vague?
I think everybody's had a different view of what a smart city is. For us, it's very clear. We look at the city, we look at what can be improved. And what we're trying to do is help cities do this in a very simple way.
Give us an example.
So we produce an application that can forecast air quality 5 days in advance. And the benefit of this today is that 5 days in advance, if you know you're going to have a bad air day, you can begin to put tolling or low emission zones around schools or around public spaces and parks so that you can create, you know, clean air zones across the city.
Can you give us an example of the types of data sources that you're using with this type of air quality prediction?
We have sensors across the city. We can locate those anywhere we like. Very easy, very cheap. We then have an application that illustrates and shows you the forecast across the city.
So a smart city, so the heart of it then again is the collection of data.
Right.
And then you combine the data and do the analytics in order to figure out connections that otherwise you couldn't have seen.
Exactly. What you then do is create a city dashboard of applications. And as a citizen, like I am here in New York, I can use the applications that are relevant to me to catch a cab, to take the subway, to take the right train, to monitor my energy use. So the applications become very personalized to each individual, and each of those will be a different menu of options for every citizen of the city.
Obviously, you have sensors and you have devices and they're generating data and the data flows into a platform. How do we use that data?
We have a platform called MindSphere. It's an open source IoT platform. You can take the data, you can combine these data sets, and you can look for ways of making the underlying infrastructure more efficient. And then you can just build applications on top, which will help transport operators or energy utility operators run their infrastructure in a better way. And frankly, if cities don't do this, they will be left behind.
Why is inefficiency so important?
In 30 years from now, we're going to have to consume probably 20% of the energy we consume today. You're going to have probably twice as many people moving around our cities with the same number of vehicles. So we have to really start thinking how all of our infrastructure plays together.
And when you introduce smart city elements, what are you doing differently?
Cities now have to reach different targets than they've ever reached before. So, you know, most have quite aggressive targets to 2025. Some are even pledging carbon neutral by 2050. This is not far away. And our platform can very simply, within minutes actually, you can connect a piece of infrastructure to a cloud-based platform.
And people working for the city as well as citizens can make various types of decisions
right,
based on that, on those new data streams.
So this is the way the smart city technology is evolving, and it will evolve completely differently in each and every city. So the building blocks will be the same, but how you build up that application landscape will be very different.
Some of that data will be pushed out to consumers, to subway riders.
Right.
Other data will be pushed to, say, management at Transport
exactly.
for London.
Exactly.
So that they can take certain steps. Everybody operating on that same set of data.
So what we want to do with this smart city landscape is provide the city with more control over these decisions and control over this infrastructure.
Talk to us about e-mobility, autonomous vehicles.
Yeah, so e-mobility is a tremendous topic. We have a city performance tool which helps model different technology choices around the city and shows cities what impact they have on CO2 and also air quality emissions. We can even actually calculate how many jobs it creates from taking different technology choices. And we can also see what's going to happen. For example, in Los Angeles, the electrical energy consumption will go up by 1,500% by 2050 on the trajectory of electrification that they have in their transport fleets. No city is prepared for that level of increase. So in the US here, we're seeing the beginnings of an amazing transformation in the way electrification is going to alter the city and the way we think about moving our transport fleets.
Okay, Martin Powell, thank you so much.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you.